Hello, welcome. Now I am going to explain you line by line the poem On His Blindness written by John Milton. Milton was a voracious reader. That means he read a lot. He used to stay up to midnight many times and he used to read. Maybe because of that he lost his eyesight by the age of 42. It was very early. He was very sad that he could not do anything for God. So when he was young, he was in the service of the Commonwealth. He was an officer there, an ambassador, working with Oliver Cromwell, and he wrote a lot that time. But most of them were political pamphlets. But he knew that he had a great talent as a writer, and later he came to know that he had a talent to compose beautiful poems. But in this poem he bemoans, or he is worried, that he could not do anything while he had eyes. He only wrote many things about other subjects, and in this poem he bemoans his ill fate that he lost his eyesight before he could serve God. That was his worry. When I consider how my light is spent, ere half my days, he says. Half my days means half of my life, the total life. He takes it to be around 80 years. Now 40 is already lost. Another 40 is left. Before, air means before. Before half, he has lost his sight. Into this dark world and wide. Now he is afraid of living in the wild, dark place. Because now it would be wide because the darkness has no end. Therefore, it seems to be wide for him and dark as it is. So now he is worrying how he has to pull on being blind. And that one talent which is death to hide, he says. Death to hide, that means this is almost like a suicide. If he hides that talent, what is the talent? Composing poetry. He knew well that he could compose beautiful poetry. Therefore, he says, it is death to hide. That means he should not hide it. Lodged with me, useless. That means now that talent is there. Writing talent is there. But it is useless because it is not being used, especially in service of God. That is what is his worry. Though my soul more bent to serve here with my maker, that means I am so inclined to serve the God. Here it is maker. Maker is God. He desires to work for him. So how would he serve God? By composing poetry. And present my true account, lest he returning child. Here it means he had a deep belief that after the death he has to go in front of God. Even we also believe, Hindus also believe that we afterwards we have to go and give our account there. What have we done there? So before he went there, that is before his death, he wanted to do a lot that would serve God. This was what is his idea. And now he is deprived of it. That chance he has lost because he cannot write poetry because he is blind. This is what is his worry. He says God would chide. That means he would ask the question, what have you done? That means if he says that he had been blind and he could not do anything, then definitely he might Ask him. There are other ways of serving. What did you do? So, he never wanted that he should be blamed by the God. Doth God exact day labor, light denied? Now he asks the question to his own conscience. It is not a question asked to God. He wants to ask, doth God exact? That means, does God expect day labor? That means hard labor, physical labor, or any work you can interpret as light denied. That means without vision, without eyesight. Then how is it possible? I fondly ask means foolishly I ask this. He knows that it is a silly question. That's why he says to himself, I fondly ask. But patience to prevent that murmur soon replies. Patience means his own patience. Before asking God this question, his own conscience, when he introspected and asked himself whether this question is valid, then patiently he waited for thinking or for reflecting. So when he reflected, thought or pondered, that time he got the answer to himself. What is that? That now it is personified here. Patience is personified. So patient is intervening. He is preventing this question which he is going to ask the God. So he says, no, you don't ask God. I am here to answer you. So his own conscience, inner voice says, what does he say? God doth not need either man's work or his own gifts. That means God is so great that he doesn't need anything from human beings. He is already self-sufficient. Further he says, who best bear his mild yoke? Best bear mild yoke means those who involve in their work and do their job sincerely. Yoke. Mild yoke means here doing moderate work. They serve him the best. Sincerely, those who do their job, they are the best people, those who serve God. That is the best service one can do to the God. Special things are not required. Do your job sincerely and honestly. That will serve the God. This answer comes from within again. Nobody is telling him. His own conscience gives him the answer. His state is kingly, he says. That means his means God. God is royal. He doesn't need any help from human beings. He doesn't need any gifts. And he says, thousand at his bidding, speed and post over land and ocean without rest. Thousands of names are there for him. That means the moment he gives an order, just when it is out of his lips, they carry out his order very fast. On land, on sea, wherever it is. So, God doesn't need anybody, any human beings. They also serve who only stand and wait. That is, it is to himself. That means people like him. Those who are patient, those who are waiting for the God's command. Those people also serve as good as the others. There is no difference. So, he is now convinced that he is waiting for God's command and he would carry out whenever he orders him. So, now he is satisfied that being blind is no problem for him. Now, it is time for you to judge my work. If it is useful, press the thumbs up. Thank you and Jai Hind.